Hey, what's going on, YouTube family? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here and this is your first time seeing my face, my name is Mark. Please remember to slash that like button. And also, I know, before you get started, I know there's some people in the back. You got commitment issues. I got commitment issues. But I got a problem that'll solve and remedy all of that. So why don't you just annihilate that subscribe button? And also, to keep up to date with me, hit that post notification bell. And if you still have reservations about it, you can still think of this like a swipe left on Tinder, like we doing a YouTube dating process. But, and also, leave me comments down below. But I think I've talked enough, so let's just jump straight into these videos. Let's go!
They call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't a...
We should never be friends! Ooh, I love how that started off already.
I saw you again last night. You were with somebody and so was I. Met you in the bathroom at 12:05. And I fucked you again. We can never be friends. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm not myself. I'm not myself when you're around now.
See, this is why I love MGK, because he is so multi-dimensional as an artist. This is what I talk about when I speak about artists. I love when artists showcase that they are not one-dimensional, that they are not monolithic, that they can have their hands in many pots. When you hear someone like Machine Gun Kelly come to a track and you think about him and you sit there and think about him rapping and you're like, oh, he's a dope lyricist and he has bars and punchlines and metaphors and double entendres, but then when you sit there and get to this, and then you get reminded that no, he can actually sing and he can actually perform and give you vocals and raw vocals at that, and make such a connection, and that he makes the connection with not only his rap songs, but he makes this real deep, sincere connection with also his ballads as well. And that's what I love about him as an artist, because he's so transparent and so authentic. Like, there's nothing fake about him. Like, you don't get anything like that's fake, that's not tangible. Like, you can really relate to Machine Gun Kelly whenever you listen to a song of his. And that's what I love about him, because I feel like ever since I've been doing reactions of Machine Gun Kelly, because I am new to reacting to him. I've only been reacting to him like probably like the last 2 months, but just reacting to his music, I see how authentically of a man he is and how great of a man he is. And then also looking at some of his videos of how deeply connected he is with his fans. And that's dope. Like, that just showcases that he doesn't let the fame get to his head, that he's very appreciative and glad to be here and occupy this space, and very grateful for the people who have allowed him to put his talents on full display. And that's what I love about a Machine Gun Kelly, because he speaks to those people who don't feel like, oh, I'm better than everybody, and doesn't sit there and engulf that and think that, oh, just because I'm in this position that I can't relate to you. If that makes sense. So let me jump back into this, because I know y'all probably tired of me speaking, but that was dope. I like this already. Let me take this back.
Last night, you were with somebody and so was I. Met you in the bathroom at 12:05. And I fucked you again. We can never be friends. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm not myself. I'm not myself when you're around now.
I love that transition. And what I love about this is he's giving me like, I don't know if any of you guys know the group Simple Plan, but he's giving me Simple Plan, Welcome to My Life. If you've never heard of them, check out that song as well, because he's definitely giving me like a Simple Plan, Welcome to My Life type of vibe on this track. And I love it because Simple Plan, with the especially the lead singer and just how they, and even just the ones, the guys who are playing the instruments, they made such a huge effort and cohesive effort of like ingratiating themselves within the music and having such a bond and connection with the lyrics and the musicality of it all. And that's what I feel like MGK does. Like, he has, like, he forges this bond, like he like almost has like this chemical bond where he infuses himself and ingratiates himself not only with the lyrics but also the beat, so he becomes one. Like, if you think of, let me think of a analogy. I don't know if you guys watch Pokemon, but if you watch Pokemon and you watch Ash, when he had Greninja, and when Greninja mega evolved, he didn't have to use the mega stone. Sorry to get into anime, but he didn't have to use the mega stone to sit there and have used mega evolution. The bond that Ash and Greninja had was like so tight and so forged that they forged this connection that he just showcased his power, and he would, they, and that they were so such an impactful duo and a dynamic duo. And that's what Machine Gun Kelly, I feels like, does. Like, he like mega evolves on tracks because he has such a bond with not only the lyrics but also the musicality and also the beat with it, and he marriages that together, and he like becomes so powerful and this becomes such a force and so dynamic on the track, if that makes sense. Whoa, amazing. Let me take that back a little bit. I'm sorry, y'all probably like, be quiet, but he does what he does.
Sick inside from seeing you next to a friend of mine. We didn't speak, but I read your mind. Both telling lies, our alibis didn't work this time. I'm leaning in the night. She's an angel with the right touch. Keep on all the lights. You can show me what you like. Help me put back on my clothes. Make sure nothing's on my nose. Can't even tell my clothes are sluggish. Nobody knows. I think that I saw you again last night. You were with somebody, so was I. Met you in the bathroom at 12:05. And I'll fuck you again. We can never be friends, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the precision how he's hitting that beat with that flow, because it seems like it's almost like if he misses like even one count, like he'll throw, like it'll almost throw off the whole song. Just the accuracy and the poise and the precision and the vocal control and the breath control that he's doing on that one part, on that one sound bit right there, to be able to do that and stay on register and key, amazing. I love that. Let me take this back a little bit.
Yeah, I know that I said I was at home. Okay, yeah, you caught me. I thought that you said you were all alone. Look at you lying.
I think that I saw you again last night. You were smiling, so was I. Met you in the bathroom at 12:05. And I fought you again. We can never be friends, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was dope. I like that.
Hey, USAA.
Okay, so let's quickly talk about MGK with Why Are You Here? And I love this because because of the multidimensionality that, and I don't even know if that's a word, but we're going to create it as a word just because it's MGK and just because of how dope he is, just the multidimensional artist that he is and how he showcases that he has his hands in many pots and how this gave me rock. It gave me alternative. It gave me metal. I love how he can also give me lyrical rap, but then also give me like that hood, like almost rap style as well. Like he just has his hands in so many different pots that makes him so multidimensional and non-monolithic. And this is what makes me gravitate towards him as an artist, because he's able to tap into some sort of like inner strength within him. Artistry, like monster that consumes his body, and he just like goes off, like he gets busy. Like my only thing, and this is like not even, it's like not even a critique, it's like that I wish that this would have been longer. Like almost, I almost feel like this, it may have been just like a freestyle almost, like because it was only two, it was like right under the 3 minute mark. So this is probably something that he just had to, just wanted to get off his chest and like just play around with. But other than that, he did a phenomenal job with this track. I thought, I loved it. I love the alternative rocky type of vibe he gave me, because like I said, he has his hands in so many different pots and he's so multi-dimensional with it. Like you can never say that MGK is just singular. Like you cannot box him into a box, and if you try to box him into it, he's going to box back like a boxer. Like he's always going to be on the defense and box himself back out and come out with the 1-2-3 because of how amazing he is. And this is why I have become a fan of his over doing these reactions, because he's just that damn good. Excuse my language, I don't want to curse on here, but I just love when artists sit there and tap into and make me think and can tap into these raw emotions that I have and make me just contemplate about myself almost in general. And I think he did an amazing job. MGK hands down is like dope. That's all I can sit there and say. Hashtag dope, hashtag period with a T, and the T stands for the end. No debate. So with that being said, I'm not rating this because I thought that this was amazing. So let me know what you thought of MGK with Why Are You Here in the comments below. And with that being said, please remember to be safe out there. Remember to stay awesome. Be awesome, because you guys are all awesome. This is your boy Mark, and I'm signing off. Deuces. Peace.
They call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't about the race either, it's the marathon.